Many cameras today offer dual native ISO, but what is it? And is it worth the hype? Before we discuss dual native ISO, we need to understand what ISO is and what native means. Many people describe ISO as the sensitivity of the sensor, but that's not actually correct. The sensor sensitivity is fixed when the sensor is manufactured, and there's nothing we can do to change that afterwards. So what is ISO? Well, ISO is an amplification of the signal created by the sensor. Now, I'm old enough to remember using the gain button on some of my first cameras, where we could boost the signal by 3 dB, 6 dB, or even 12 dB. But adding gain meant that the quality of our picture would significantly decrease. Well, ISO does exactly that. It simply applies gain to the signal generated by the sensor. 6 dB of gain equals one stop, or doubling the ISO. That means when you switch your camera from 100 ISO to 200 ISO, you've just applied 6 dB of gain to your image. At 6 dB, you can easily see degradation and significant noise. Now at 12 dB, the image is no longer usable. Native ISO is set by the camera manufacturer to be the ISO level where no gain is applied to the signal. You'll need to check your camera to find out exactly what its native ISO is. So for example, on my Sony FX6, the native ISO in CineEI is set to 800. That means at 800 ISO, 0 dB gain is added. 6 dB would be added if I switch to 1600 ISO, and 12 dB would be applied at 3200 ISO. Now, what is dual native ISO? Well, it's exactly what it sounds like. Cameras with dual native ISO have two different native ISO settings, a low base ISO and a high base ISO. Going back to my FX6, the low base ISO is native at 800, and the high base is native at 12,800 ISO. That means if I switch to the high base ISO, 0 dB is applied at 12,800 ISO, 6 dB would be applied at 25,600, and 12 dB at 51,200, etc. You should still shoot at the low base native ISO as much as possible. The image quality is just significantly better than the high base native ISO. But the real comparison to consider is between an image shot at 10,000 ISO and the same image shot at 12,800 ISO. Which one do you think should have more noise? 10,000 ISO or 12,800 ISO? Well, 10,000 ISO is 3.5 stops from the low base native of 800 ISO. That's over 20 dB of gain. Now, if we switch the camera to the high base ISO with a native ISO of 12,800, 0 dB is applied. And you can see how much cleaner our image is. And that's why you should consider a camera with dual native ISO. It makes it possible to capture high quality images in low light. There's a reason why with the Sony FX6, you have to switch mode in the menu in order to deviate from the native ISO. You're actually better off switching to high base ISO than raising the ISO in the low base. Bottom line is you should only shoot in native ISO and use your other camera settings or add more lights in order to properly expose your shot. I hope this makes sense. Let me know what your experience is shooting in high base ISO. Thanks a lot for watching, and as a token of my appreciation, I'd like to offer you my free camera setting cheat sheet. Just follow the link below to download the free cheat sheet. Thanks again, and happy filming.